Barakatha Yahuwah, Barakatha Yahuwah Shai, Kol Halonim La Yahuwah, Bahasham Yahuwah Shai, Barakaha Kodash, which means all praises to Yahuwah is the name of the Heavenly Father. Bahasham is in the name. Yahuwah Shai is the name of His only begotten Son, who the world eagerly called Jesus Christ. Barakaha Kodash means in the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Truth, only way to worship the Father and the Son. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Peace, blessings, and salutations to all you brothers who are preaching the gospel in truth and in sincerity, always in charity. It's Brother Mathathi from Great Millstone Camp, La Brenchon on Des Moines. And as you can see, the title of the lesson is entitled Hot in Pursuit of Salvation. And it's inspired through the Holy Spirit that through the Apostle Ramlov lesson that he did yesterday. You know, and Salakia, the name of the lesson is slipping my mind at the moment. You know, but within that lesson, he read Philippians, the third chapter. Matter of fact, let's go to that. This Philippians 3. And let's start at 12. It says, not as though I had already attained, either were already perfect, but I follow after. Now, when you look into that Greek word for follow after, it's the Greek word dioko, which is G1377. It says to make, to run or flee, put to flight, drive away, to run swiftly in order to catch a person or thing, right? And Apostle Ramlov went into this definition within his lesson, which inspired that topic, right? It says to press on vigorously of one who in a race runs swiftly to reach the goal, to pursue, right? And it says in a hostile manner, right? And he mentioned Ashael. Now, for brothers who don't know who Ashael is, how the hell do you spell his name? I just do it this way. Now, this is the book of 2 Samuel, chapter 2 and verse 18. It says, and there were three sons of Zeruiah, which Zeruiah, when you go into it, is the sister of King David. You see? So, Joab, Abishai, and Ashael are King David's nephews. So it says, and Ashael was as light of foot as a wild roe, right? And a roe, when you go into it, or gazelle. So you see how swift and how light-footed the deer are, or gazelle, when they run, when they leap, when they hop. You see? Verse 19, and Ashael pursued after Abner. He was pursuing him, what? In that hostile manner. And in going, he turned not to the right hand nor to the left from following Abner, right? Now, you can go into the history and read this story, you know, but the point is that even when faced with death, he didn't turn away from following after Abner, man. And see, and this is the same mentality we must have within this walk of ours. So let's go back to Philippians chapter 3 and verse 12. It says, not as though I had already attained, either were already perfect, but I follow after. Let's go into that word once again. It says to press on figuratively of one who in a race runs swiftly to reach the goal, to pursue in a way whatsoever, to harass, trouble, molest, right? It goes into the persecution that one suffers going through this walk, right? It says metaphorically to pursue, to seek after eagerly, earnestly endeavor to acquire, man. You see, and this must be our mentality. No matter what persecution, no matter what trials and tribulations we go through, we continue to follow or to press toward that mark. So let's keep reading. It says, but I follow after, if that I may apprehend that for which also I am apprehended of HaMashiach Yahweh Shai. Yeah, man. And we hoping to what? To receive that salvation. For the reason why Yahweh Shai called us into this. He apprehended us in order for us to do what? To apprehend the salvation that's at hand. You see, verse 13, brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended yet. We ain't there yet, right? But this one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth unto those things which are before. So it's a day by day deal that we're a part of, man. Not what we did yesterday, the day before, the week before, you know. But what have we done for the Lord today and each day moving forward, right? What are we doing to achieve that salvation each day as we see the day of salvation drawing closer and closer, man? So each day is another opportunity for us to draw closer unto Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai. To draw closer to what? To salvation. As salvation draws closer to us. You see, but if we're not doing those necessary things that's required of us in order to achieve that salvation, that day of salvation going to pass us over, man. We don't want to fall into that, right? But it says, verse 14, I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of the Most High in HaMashiach Yahweh Shai, man. Now, when you go into that word press, it's the same Greek word. You see, diako, which means to swiftly pursue, right? So now when Apostle Ramla was doing a lesson, the first scripture that popped into my mind was 1 Corinthians chapter 9 and verse 24. It says, know ye not that they which run in a race run all? And when you go into that word run, it's the Greek word treko. It says to run of persons in haste, of those who run in a race course, metaphorically of doctrine rapidly propagated, by a metaphor taken from runners in a race, to exert oneself, strive hard, to spend one's strength in performing or attaining something. You see, word occurs in Greek writings denoting to incur extreme peril, which it requires the exertion of all one's effort to overcome. You see that, man? And this is the effort and energy one must put into this word in order to achieve salvation, man. And that comes through what? That comes through, first off, prayer, as is written in James, the first chapter. If any man lack wisdom, let him pray unto Yahweh Basham Yahweh Shai, that giveth to all men liberally and upbraideth not. But we have to ask in faith, not wavering. Because if we waver, then we won't receive anything of the Lord, right? So when we pray and we ask the Lord to fill us with his Holy Spirit, to fill us with the spirit of wisdom, then what? Give attendance to reading, exhortation, and doctrine, as it is written in 1 Timothy, the fourth chapter. Right? So it says, down at the bottom, as an alternate in certain senses, to run or walk hastily. Right? So it's to run. So I'm going to read this again. 1 Corinthians 9, verse 24. It says, know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize? So run that ye may obtain. Exactly. Just like how in a literal Olympic race, there is only one first place winner. Well, it's the same thing within this walk of ours. There's only one first place winner. You see, now we understand that there's what, 144,000 spots, but each one of those, it's only one spot for each individual. So what are we doing to attain that glory, man? What are we doing to obtain one of those spots? There's a scripture in the book of Proverbs that says that a man's gift maketh room for him. Maketh room for him where? Maketh room for him amongst great men. You see? Make it room for him within the chariot. Make it room for him at the table of Yahweh Shai. You see? Verse 25. And every man that striveth for the mastery. You go into that word mastery. To enter a contest, contend in the gymnastic games. This is what Paul is comparing it unto, right? To contend with adversaries, fight metaphorically, to contend, struggle with difficulties and dangers, to endeavor with strenuous zeal. Woo! Strive to obtain something, man. It says to endeavor with strenuous zeal. Let's get that word strenuous. Oh my God. Let's get that word. It says requiring or using great exertion. That's one of those. That was that not the treko definition, right? Or was it the diako? You know, but see, but those two words in the context we're using is synonymous with each other. You see, so it says strenuous zeal. That zeal goes back into that fervency, that fire that one has for this faith, man. As it is written in Jeremiah, the 20th chapter. Jeremiah said that thy word was like a fire shut up in my bones, and I was weary and I could not stay. That's that zeal. That's that fire. That's that passion that one has within themselves for what? For their craft. In order to what? To achieve the goal that's at hand. You see? Let's go back. So it says, verse 25, and every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things, Now, they do it to obtain a corruptible crown. You look at guys like Floyd Mayweather and LeBron James, Michael Jordan, right? These different athletes, Usain Bolt, these different athletes within their different crafts. Look at how much discipline and commitment that they gave unto what they love to do. And they did it for a corruptible crown. They're doing it for something that's going to fade away, that something's going to die with this society. But it says, but we an incorruptible. See, what we're doing is going to last into the ages, man. It's going to last for eternity. Verse 26, I therefore so run, not as uncertainly. So fight I, not as one that beateth the air. Meaning what? We have the goal in hand. We know what we're running for. We know what we're fighting for. I press toward the mark of the prize of the high calling, man. Understanding what the goal is. And that goal is salvation. You see? Verse 27, but I keep under my body and bring it into subjection, lest by any means when I have preached to others, I myself should be a castaway, man. So what? That's using that discipline. When you go into that word keep under, it's the Greek word hubiazo. And it says to beat black and blue, to smite so as to cause bruises and livid spots. Now that reminds me of a precept where, matter of fact, how is it worded? Blueness. Yep. This Proverbs 20 and 30, it says the blueness of a wound cleanses away evil, right? It's like when your child is doing something wrong, you spank him, you whoop his ass, and he know not to do that again, man. So do stripes the inward parts of the belly, meaning in our mind, you see? So do stripes in our mind. That's why when certain things would go down with our forefathers, for King David, for example, when he messed up, what does the scripture say? His heart smote him, you see? According to Sirach, the 23rd chapter, wisdom came into his mind and cut that thought that he had or made him realize his fault. And it's the same thing with us, man. So going back to I keep under my body, it says to beat black and blue, to smite so as to cause bruises and livid spots, not physically, but mentally, but spiritually, disciplining ourselves, cutting ourselves off from these different lusts and desires of the flesh. In order for us to what? To feed the spirit more and more. Just like how those so-called entertainers and athletes, they buffet their body. Well, this is the next definition. Like a boxer, one buffets his body, handle it roughly, disciplined by hardships, man. And it's the same thing as us within this faith of ours. Denying ourselves of these different worldly lusts or fleshly desires, right? In order for us to strengthen the inner man. You see? Matter of fact, Salaki, in order for Yahweh Basham Yahushai to strengthen our inner man. You see? Matter of fact, let me get that. Because that's what it's about. This is the book of Ephesians 3 and 16. That he would grant you according to the riches of his glory to be strengthened with might by his spirit in the inner man. You see that? So it says that the Most High might grant unto us through Yahawashah, right, the riches of his glory to be strengthened with might by his spirit in the inner man. That's talking about in our mind. You see that? So that's what we're striving toward, man. Keeping the goal at hand. Keeping our eyes single as it is written in Matthew, the 6th chapter. Right? So now, what I had did was I looked up certain words. Like for instance, this one, G5143, in 1 Corinthians 9, it says I run, not as one that beateth the air. So this is the Greek word for run, right? You see that right here. This is a good one. Galatians 5:7, it says, ye did run well. Who did hinder you that ye should not obey the truth? So he's speaking to the Galatians that what? They caused something to interfere with their pursuit in salvation, man. We can't allow anything to interfere with our pursuit in salvation. You see? Philippians 2:16. Verse 15. Man, verse 12. It says, whereof, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. That word work out. To perform, accomplish, achieve. To work out, i.e. to do that from which something results. Woo! Of things bring about result in. To fashion, i.e. render one fit for a thing. To work fully, that is accomplish. What did Yahweh Shah say? He said, how am I straightened? Man, let me get that. Luke 12 and 50. But I have a baptism to be baptized with, and how am I straightened till it be accomplished, man? That word straightened. To press together, right? Word straights mean difficult or in a tight position, you know? So what? To hold together any hole, lest to fall to pieces or something, fall away from it. To hold together with constraint, to compress, to press together with the hand, right? So to hold completely, to hold fast, to be held closely, to hold together, to compress, to compel, perplex, preoccupy, right? So we're straightened until what? Until this word is accomplished, man. That's our, that we're hot in pursuit of salvation, man. That's it. So we're straightened on every side, man. We're pressed. In order to what? In order to achieve the goal that's at hand. That's it. There's no other option. When you look at the mindset of these different guys, my favorite player being Kobe Bryant, right? He was like, nothing else mattered, man. In his mind, he had to be the greatest to lace up them shoes, man. That was in his mind. So what? So he was straightened until what? Until he achieved the goal that he had set for himself. And it's the same thing as us. Same thing, right? If they're able to do that for a corruptible crown, once again, for something that's going to vanish away with this place, how much more us for life eternal, right? And also, and Yahweh Shah also said in the book of St. John 4 and 34, Yahweh Shah saith unto them, my meat is to do the will of him that sent me and to finish his work, to finish our course, man. Like Paul wrote unto Timothy, you know, finish the course. That's what it's about, man. Hot in pursuit of salvation. You see? Now let's go. Where was I? Well, we was in the Philippians. Philippians 2 and 12 again. It says, wherefore, my beloved, as ye have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. Now, we look up that word work out, which is what, man? To perform or to accomplish something, man, to work fully. Verse 13, for it is the heavenly Father which worketh in you both to will and to do of his good pleasure. So that's why it's all of Yahweh Basham Yahweh Shah. We must ask him for these different traits and qualities that's needed to walk in the spirit. Right. And we're going to read about some of these traits and qualities. Right. Verse 14. Do all things without murmurings and disputings, that ye may be blameless and harmless, the sons of the heavenly Father, without rebuke, in the midst of a crooked and perverse nation, among whom ye shine as lights in the world, holding forth the word of life, that I may rejoice in the day of Yahweh Shah, that I have not run in vain, neither labored in vain. You see? So that what? So that our ministry and those who are listening, right? That it may not be in vain, man. So encouraging the brothers to what? To continue in the faith. Keep this mindset. You see? So that none of our works are in vain. So that this labor or this run or this race that we're running is not in vain, man. You see? Because each individual have to give his all to achieve the goal that's at hand. That's why Paul told Timothy Take heed unto thyself and unto the doctrine, continue in them, because in doing so thou shalt save thyself and them that hear thee. And those that are hearing you are what? They're applying the knowledge that you're giving them. They're taking heed to the experience and the correction that you're giving them. So that what? So that this labor may not be in vain. You see that? So from there, I think I had I know I had another word. Yep, the 1377. The G1377, which that's the same work a word as follow after in the book of Philippians 3rd chapter, and also the Greek word or the word press in Philippians the 3rd chapter as well. Which Greek word was diazo, if I'm not mistaken. But let's see. And as you can see, it's a lot of definitions of persecution. And that was one of the definitions of it when we looked it up, right? Yep, see, they go follow after and press toward the mark. It's a good one. 1 Thessalonians 5 and 15. See that none render evil for evil unto any man, but ever follow that which is good, both among yourselves and to all men. You see? 1 Timothy 6 and 11. But thou, O man of the Most High, flee these things. What? The lust of the flesh, the lust of the eye, the pride of life. Right? And follow after, same as press. Dioko. Dioko was the word. I'm sorry. Dioko is the Greek word. You see? So it says follow after righteousness, these qualities, these traits, these characteristics that we spoke about earlier. Follow after righteousness, godliness, faith, love, patience, meekness. You see? So if we're following after these different things, guess what? These things is going to lead us into salvation. 2 Timothy 2 and 22. Flee also youthful lusts, but follow righteousness, faith, charity, peace, with them that call on the Lord out of a pure heart. You see that? I think it's one more, right? This is a good one. Hebrews 12 and 14. Follow peace with all men and holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord Yahweh Shai, man. So we have to follow after these things, right? Just like how Peter told us. This is the book of 2 Peter 1 and 4. It says, whereby are given unto us exceeding great and precious promises, that by these ye might be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust. And besides this, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, and to virtue knowledge. And it says add, right? To supply, furnish, present, to be supplied, minister to, assisted, fully supply, aid or contribute, add or minister. Ooh, nourishment. That's a good one right there, man. You know? So we should be adding unto these things. We should be growing within these different characteristics. It says, and besides this, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, and to virtue knowledge, and to knowledge temperance, and to temperance patience, and to patience godliness. We should be following after these things. And to godliness, brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness, charity. For if these things be in you and abound, they shall make you that ye shall neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Yahweh Shah HaMashiach. But he that lacketh these things is blind and cannot see afar off, and hath forgotten that he was purged from his old sins. Wherefore, the rather, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and election sure. See, what we do know is we've been called, but we don't know if we've been chosen. So we have to do what? To give diligence to make that calling and election, which that word election is the act of choosing. So it's that chosenship, right? If that's a word. You see, chosen, as you can see down there in the Strong's definition. So give diligence to make our calling and election sure, for if we do these things, we shall never fall. For so an entrance shall be ministered unto you abundantly into the everlasting kingdom of our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shah HaMashiach. You see that? In hot pursuit of salvation. Wherefore, I will not be negligent to put you always in remembrance of these things, though ye know them and be established in the present truth. Yea, I think it meet, as long as I am in this tabernacle, to stir you up by putting you in remembrance, man. In remembrance of what? Of these different things, right? This is the Book of Wisdom of Solomon. Chapter 6. And let's see. Let's start at 15. To think therefore upon her, her being wisdom, is perfection of wisdom. And whoso watcheth for her shall quickly be without care. She goeth about seeking such as are worthy of her, showeth herself favorably unto them in the ways, and meeteth them in every thought. And the reason she meets us in every thought is because we're following after her in all our ways. It says what? To follow after, or to chase, to pursue. Now this is the book of Sirach 14. And I started 20. Blessed is the man that doeth meditate good things in wisdom, and that reasoneth of holy things by his understanding. He that considereth her ways in his heart shall also have understanding in her secrets. Go after her as one that traceth. You see that? And lie in wait in her ways. That reminds me of Revelation, the 14th chapter, in the 4th verse. It says, these are they which were not defiled with women, for they are virgins, meaning they continue in continue thou in the things that thou hast learned, being assured of, knowing of whom thou hast learned them from. So they didn't wander off into these different philosophies, into these strange women, right? They continue steadfastly in the apostles' doctrine. Paul said that I espouse you unto one husband, that I may present you as a chaste virgin. See, that's what these letters were about. These letters were about making sure that the church was in proper order according to what's written. You see, these are they which were not defiled with women, for they are virgins. These are they which follow the Lamb. What's that word, follow? It says to follow one who precedes, join him as his attendant, accompany him. To join one as a disciple, become or be his disciple, side with his party. To be in the same way with, that is to accompany. Ooh. To be in the same way with, man. Yahusha said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. You see? In the book of Isaiah, it speaks about a highway, which is a way of righteousness, man. And this is the way. Walk ye in it. So it says, these are they which follow the Lamb whithersoever he goeth. These were redeemed from among men, being the first fruits unto the Most High and unto the Lamb. So now let's go back. Sirach 14 and 21 again. He that considereth her ways in his heart shall also have understanding in her secrets. Go after her as one that traceth, and lie in wait in her ways. He that prieth in at her windows shall also hearken at her doors. He that doeth lodge near her house shall also fasten pin in her walls. Hot pursuit, man. Hot pursuit. Wherever she is, I gotta be there too. He shall pitch his tent nigh unto her, and shall lodge in a lodging where good things are. He shall set his children under her shelter, and shall lodge under her branches. By her he shall be covered from heat, and in her glory shall he dwell. You see? So now let's jump back. Wisdom of Solomon 6, and I believe it was in verse 15. It says, to think therefore upon her is the perfection of wisdom, and whoso watcheth for her shall quickly be without care. For she goeth about seeking such as are worthy of her, showeth herself favorably unto them in the ways, and meeteth them in every thought. For the very true beginning of her is the desire of discipline. Right? That goes back into I keep under my body. He that runneth in a race runneth all. Right? But one receiveth the prize. He that striveth for the masteries, I just butchered that whole little passage that we read earlier, man. It's a lot, you know. But it's showing you, man, that it's discipline within the pursuit of salvation, you know. There's trials and tribulations and persecutions that's along this road. But it says the very true beginning of her is the desire of discipline, and the care of discipline is love. And love is the keeping of her laws, and the giving heed unto her laws is the assurance of incorruption. And incorruption maketh us near unto the Most High. You see, it says it's the assurance of incorruption. Lining up with that 1 Corinthians 9, that incorruptible crown that we're striving for. But it speaks about striving lawfully, meaning according to what's written, you see. Verse 20. Therefore, the desire of wisdom bringeth to a kingdom, man. So being in a hot pursuit of salvation means we're following after this wisdom. We're following hard after this wisdom, man. Going back to the analogy that the apostle gave with Ashael that we read earlier, how he was following after Abner. You see, verse 21, if your delight be then in thrones and scepters, O ye kings of the people, honor wisdom that ye may reign forevermore. You know, and I feel like that's a good place to stop it. You know, the Wadi Yahweh Basham Yahweh for giving me the spirit to do this, you know, because, man, hey, it's a beautiful thing that we're a part of, man. You know, and we all must show the same diligence until the full assurance of hope until the end. You know, each and every last one of us, man. So, Lord will, I hope this was edifying. Tawadi Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shah, for giving me the spirit to do this lesson. I'm going to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Baruch HaKodash. Double honors to the apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Peace, blessings, and salutations to all you brothers who are preaching the gospel in truth and in sincerity, always in charity, who's rightly dividing the word of truth directly and correctly. Peace, blessings, salutations to you brothers, man, you few sisters that's watching as well, and to all your families. Shalom.